Hello again. Today's project is going to be a goblet, and I'm going to be turning it out of this nice piece of beech, coloured beech, and I've got to put three captive rings on it and be using the old captive ring tool that I did a demo on a little while ago, put it to the test and do it on a real piece this time and see how it works. And I'll be finishing off with friction polish, and we'll see how that turns out. Nothing to do with goblets or captive rings. The arbor that I use for the sanding discs, power sanding bowls, has split around here. So I thought, right, get a replacement. And I went on eBay and I came across this little chappy. As you notice, it's a much lower profile than this. It is much stronger, still flexible as that, but much stronger, and I think it'll last a lot longer. The big advantage I found was that because of the lower profile, you get much more control over your power sanding. There's much less skidding, etc. It works really, really well. And the cost, believe it or not, I bought three of these for about £4 sterling, more than one of those. So it's a good deal as well, and I think they'll last a lot longer. The site I went to is a UK site called CobbsTools. I'm not getting any payment off him or any freebies for mentioning it. It's just the site that sells it, and I thought you might like to know. The more experienced turners out there may already be aware of these, but it's a great find, and I'm very pleased I found them. Check out CobbsTools. I'll put the link down below, and you can check it out down there. He also does the sanding discs, the 2-inch sanding discs to fit on it. Okay, let's get on with the goblet. Thank you. Give it a quick blast of air. And now we're ready for the coating.
So there we have it, three rings are loose, but of course,
in my eagerness to remove the rings, I forgot to finish them, the top parts. So there will be a way of doing that, I'm sure. However, that's the rings off, and I'll have to think about how I'm going to coat these, but nevertheless, I'm sure we'll get around it. So I'll be back later. Right, I've found a way of doing the rings. I haven't finished them yet. I just put the friction polish on the rings and then literally hold them and use a polishing mop on the drill. So that's not a problem. It's not the ideal solution, but as you know, due to my eagerness, I took the rings off too soon. I'm more observant of you. That ring there is bigger than the other two. There was a reason behind that, because I thought, well, that one, let's say, will sit that way, the next one will sit that way, and then this one on top will give a bit of a contrast. Not sure if it'll work, and if it doesn't work, then I shan't do it again. But that's the reason one of the rings is bigger than the other two. Okay, just going to sand down now to 600, and then we're ready to do the final coating. Part it off, sand, palm, take the little nib off the end there, just palm sander and put some oil on there, and the job is done and it's finished. Well, thanks very much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.